talk to him if I need to get to know him and everything, right? He brought himself down so that we can do that, knowing our nature, knowing who we are and stuff, right? So, like I said, I want to start off by telling y'all a few things about myself. When I see God, I don't see him as, well, yeah, I do, right? I see him as God, right? But then I try to figure him out in the logical way before I try to see him as Almighty God, right? Because for me, that's how I think. For me, it helps me break it down so that I don't have nobody coming to me telling me, how can you believe God is this and that and this and that? And because you're always looking at him that way, you don't know how to defend him when it comes to the natural way. So, like I said, God to me is a physical being, right? He's a spiritual being also, but we have to find a balance when we trying to get to know him or when we communicating with him. So, a little bit more about myself. I don't like standing in front of people. Right? Anybody who knows me can attest to that. I'm really not that type of person. Like, this, me doing this right now, is like legit blowing my mind. So, y'all excuse me if I don't speak up. Let me know. You know, this a Bible study. It's not me preaching to y'all. I'm not a pastor. I'm nowhere near a pastor. So, if I'm saying something that's too low, let me know so I can, you know, speak up. I'm hella nervous right now, so excuse me if I do something that it's not called for. But like I said, me being nervous, I'm a very, what's it called? I basically like to share the blame, right? If I'm going to be put on the spot, y'all going to be put on the spot, right? It's not going to be just me over here just talking. So while I'm saying whatever I need to say, if I don't get questions or input, I'll be calling people out. Just so y'all know. I'm just letting y'all know. All right, this is bad. This man, you know. Yeah. All right, so our topic for today is going to be God's character. And what we're going to take from that is for his namesake. So who can tell me what namesake means?
Is it like for the reputation of like his name?
Okay. Any other things?
I was gonna say that too, like for his reputation.
Okay. Anybody else? Steven?
I was gonna say the same thing, reputation.
Okay. Well, for me, what namesake is I try to break it up, right? It is reputation, right? Because Steven, stand up real quick. This is Steven, y'all. So, that's it. This is Steven, right? He's a very tall man, you know? If this is your first time meeting Steven, and all I told you that about Steven is, this is Steven, and you leave, and I see you maybe 3 months later or something, you can sit down. And I asked you, and I asked you to tell me about Steven, what would y'all say?
He's tall.
What up?
He's like a high
top. Yeah, well, he got the flat top, right?
He's a man.
It don't look so flat right now, but still got it. What up? What else
would
y'all say about Steven?
His clothes. Colorful.
So for me, namesake is that's basically what it is, right? It's not the things that, it's not always the things that we can see, right? Sometimes it is. But you might not know that Stephen is a man of God, right? Just because he's sitting at a Bible study don't mean he's a man of God. Mm-hmm. He might just be here to review everything that we say. Right? He might just be here to yell when we say no yelling or no talking or whatever, right? But sometimes it's like we take things for the face value of what it is. We don't really look into it. So that's why I wanted to talk about God's namesake, right? Because it's his character. Right, it's his honor, it's who he is, and why he does the things that he does. And sometimes it's like, some things that God does is like, we really take it for granted, right? Like, y'all over here right now, y'all breathing, you know? That means literally God thought about waking you up this morning, right? Even while you're in here right now, you could fall over and die. not to be boony or nothing, but it can happen, right? Which means every second that you take a breath, God is thinking about your well-being, right? He's thinking, yes, let me grant him breath today, for this second, for this minute, for this hour, however long that he grants you breath. He's thinking about you. Think about how many people in this world, how many people he does that for, even if they don't know it. Coming back to even if you don't know it, like, how many of y'all, like, put yourself in God's shoes, right? It's a big shoes to fill anyway, but just try to put yourself in there. Like, think about it. If you created the whole world, right? No, let's say you created one person, right? And you told them, I want you to go from point A to point B. That's literally your whole existence, from point A to point B. And while on the way to point A, from point A to point B, they decide, nah, maybe I might hit up, you know, cookout. You know, that starts with C, that's why I said cookout. But maybe I might, you know, do this. I'm going to look at the flowers, you know. I'm going to look at the bee, wave at people. That's not what God created you for, right? He created you to go from point A to point B. So it's like, even in the commandments that God gives us, we still find ways to basically demean his authority, right? It's like you find little ways. God's created you for the sole purpose of worshiping him, right? The way you're supposed to be worshiped. I'm going to tell y'all something. If I was God, let me say this. Y'all better be glad I'm not God, right? Now, I'm going to tell y'all that right now, because if y'all know me, I like to argue, right? But if I had the authority to do whatever I want while I'm arguing, like, a lot of y'all wouldn't be here right now. I'm just going to be real with y'all. Exhibit A right there. But, you know. So you have to think about what allows God, or what makes him want to do that. Right, and that's where the character comes in. Right, the main chapter we're going to focus on today, the main Bible verse, I should say, is Psalm 23. If y'all don't have a Bible, let us know so we can put it up on the screen. Yeah. Go ahead. We have a lot of little chapters that we're going to go through, but this is basically the main one. Can you pull up the version? Like, actually, how are y'all today? I forgot to ask.
Good.
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 Pretty good.
How are you, Stone?
Doing good.
What's up, brother? How you doing? Good. Can y'all tell me about how your day went? Something that happened? I told y'all I'm gonna be calling you. Y'all think I'm boring.
We went to the mall today. I normally don't go to the mall, but, you know, it was Laura's birthday, so
okay.
Trying to, you know,
do.
Yeah, exactly.
I see.
But we were just walking, and all of a sudden, out of nowhere, I hear this guy, like, yelling at me, coming up on me. I was getting scared, and, like,
you about to fight?
I don't even know. I was about to run, but... But it was DeAndre, and he had, like, candy camera on.
Oh.
Or, like, Snapchat or something.
Damn, you did him like that. Okay.
And, like, he was spying on us. And then Steve. And then Steven comes out of nowhere, too. He's coming from another direction. Like, all these security, like, it was pretty sketchy. And then, like... But we went to his expensive Apple phone was messing up, so we went to the Apple store.
Thank you. Y'all don't know what type of arguments we had about Apple and Android. For this, like, that was a little bigger.
But yeah, basically, I wanted to ask them a few questions, and like this lady was talking to us. She was pretty nice. And then I asked, can we pray for you? And she said, like, she needs prayer for, like, calm she just said calm. So, like, you know, she needed calmness, I guess. So, yeah, we prayed for her, and she really liked it, and she said, like, amen at the end. So, she definitely, so, we, yeah, we blessed her, so. That was good.
That's a very productive day. Y'all live together, but y'all still was able to have fun outside the house. I'm sorry to put y'all on the spot. May I ask what your name is? Yeah, both of y'all actually.
I'm Courtney.
Courtney, hey Courtney. Hey,
y'all ain't saying nothing. I was getting there.
Okay, 1, 2, 3.
Hey Courtney.
So, what brings you the power of today?
Because so many people probably in this.
That's what I'm saying. We need to put a sign on the door. Because, like, no one knows.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, man.
That's Rob. Actually, no, I'm going to let you go ahead and introduce yourself. Yeah, man, come on.
Hey, guys. I'm Anthony. I'm kind of in the
How'd you find it? You know, why you
here? I actually came here my last time.
I know.
With Alea and my camera. Yeah. I was in
Florida. Oh, yeah, we know.
With mm-hmm. some friends. And enjoyed it. I got
text. And then he was like, okay. No, well, I think everybody else knew each other. For y'all that don't know, this is Growling. Go ahead,
bro.
Go ahead and introduce yourself. I just
want to
say y'all names
so y'all know I'm going to get it. Sometimes I'm slacking off. Go ahead. I'm Garland. I'm a freshman. And I found out about Power Up through the student involvement thing. And I was trying to find a place where I could just get spiritually filled. So I had already visited some places. And some places I didn't really like at all, but this place I really like, you know, this group and what y'all teach, and I really like it.
Thanks.
Well, yeah, this is Robbie. I think everybody else know each other. I'm just go ahead and actually no, go ahead to this.
Tanisha, drove here from Lynchburg,
she came all the way from here.
Yeah. Long drive.
Good though.
Yeah.
From
Lynchburg?
Lynchburg. Yeah, man. She come all the way here from Bible study. Y'all don't live right on Y'all don't want to go to Bible study. That's
like
sad.
We're at Liberty University.
That's sad. Stones, go ahead and introduce yourself.
It's like across the state.
While I came here because originally I guess my brother pretty much made me come. So it's a long story, but that's pretty much like how it started, and it's just been on this like really worldly past 3.5 years, 4 years, so it's good.
I just wanted to mess with Starling, you know, we all know Starling. You know. Without Starling I think we would all fall apart, but yeah. Getting back to the word, y'all gonna have to excuse me if I pause, because like I said, I don't really like being in front of people that much, so I wrote everything down so I wouldn't forget. So, okay, who here has a best friend?
The best one.
Best friend.
Or somebody they consider close enough to be able to tell them stuff, or You don't got a best friend.
I don't have any best friends.
Yeah. Oh, my, see, I'm mumbling. You gotta tell me I'm mumbling,
man. No,
you're not mumbling. Oh, I know. You're
come on. She called him up.
Yeah, I'm gonna call y'all out. You know. I don't gotta know you to call you up. But, my bad. Okay, so, we're gonna go around. Somebody gonna say, Courtney.
Yeah.
What does your best friend do for you that you consider your best friend? You consider you going to marry your best friend?
She puts up like all the different parts of being like as a person, you go through different parts of your life. For me, you like say if I was like very judgmental, and then you got to the point where I'm kind of like super spiritual, like I'm like, I got myself together now, I'm good. You should start doing this. She puts up with every part of me, and she doesn't judge me when I come back. When I come back, she's like, hey, you're good.
Yeah, sometimes you need to trip.
Yeah.
Go ahead, Eddie.
All right, one of my good friends, Jin Chen. Okay. He's like, Jackson. What? Yeah, Jackson. He's like, I think he's like in his 30s, young, like early 30s, but he's like, he's pretty mature in Christ, or like he just knows like the Word of God pretty well. Okay. And the thing I like about our friendship is like, we both like pray together a lot, which really helps each other. Like if one of us is feeling low, like, you know, we lift each other up, like I'll be feeling good, he'll be feeling bad, or, you know, vice, you know, versus. So we both lift each other up. And then secondly, like he's not afraid to like rebuke me. He rebukes me pretty hard. And like it's painful at first, but like I'm appreciative because like it helps me to grow, you know, and it's powerful, so, yeah.
What about you, Reggie?
So I have the best friend, though, just not really sure, but I do have really great people in my life who just listen. You know, they listen and they remember and act upon those memories. If I remember, like, if there's something I need help with or something I don't genuinely like or deal with, they heed that I said it.
See, I like that, man, because, like I said earlier, like, it's not that I don't like me and you people, but, I mean, I'll meet you, you know, hey, so keep it, you know, until, like, I see y'all maybe two or three times later on, I'm trying to talk, but I'm very awkward at that, or, like, I'm making jokes today, you know, Courtney out here laughing, like, yeah, but, it's a very awkward situation. If you see me try to meet somebody new, like, you would, yeah, it's a very sad sight. But basically, today, like I told y'all earlier, I don't like being in front of people, right? I don't like standing in front of people and talking. I took 3 semesters of communication, and that's not helping. So I made a bet with God, right, that while I'm here, if what's up, Albert, Ellie, how y'all doing? That's Albert and Ellie. I basically made a bet with God, right? I told him, if you're going to put me in this uncomfortable spot that you know I don't like to be, because supposedly for growth, you know, to be able to speak in front of people, I'm gonna try to get something out of it. Right? That's one thing that my parents have always, I think low key everybody like has had that, right? You try to look at the bright side of everything. You heard somebody tell you that before? When you were sad or when you felt like some type of way or whatever, right? In every situation that I'm put in, like I try to get the best out of it. right? Even if it's a bad situation, even if it ends on a bad note, I want to leave that situation knowing that I got something that I didn't have. Whether it's a lesson, whether it's a victory, whatever it is, I'm going to try to leave that situation with something I didn't have. And this situation that I'm in right now, like I said, I made a bet with God. I can't tell y'all what it is, but I made a bet with God. And sadly, y'all won't be my pawns and in the bet that I made with God. So if we win, it's good for all of us. I'm going to say that, right? But yeah, let's get back to the word. Psalm 23. Yeah, basically, if I'm going to suffer, y'all going to suffer, like I said. So somebody going to start reading that. It don't matter who. Go ahead.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Hence the title.
Thank you.
Yeah. Yea, through I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Amen. I have one question. Does anybody else, this church, like y'all youth, every time, you know how, like, when church is over, when they give the benediction or whatever, they're supposed to leave? Like, do y'all say that? The end part?
Yeah.
Where is it surely goodness and mercy shall follow us or whatever?
We share grace.
Share grace, okay. Yeah, because, like, ever since I was a kid, man, they've been, like, I knew that before I knew what Bible verse was. Yeah. But, see, they don't really go into the actual meaning of what this passage is. Right. This is basically David describing the character of God in my perspective. From what God gave me, this is David. Like, everybody knows about David, about being the king of Israel, being God's whatever. Like, how did he describe? He's a man after God's own heart.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Apple, what?
Apple was God.
Okay, there you go. See, I didn't know that. That's something you don't know. But, yeah. Like, he's supposed to be the closest thing to us human beings right now, but he's the farthest, right? God created us in his own image, right? Actually, scratch that. Let me say that before I say that. I hope everybody knows that God created them, everybody that's here, at least. I'm not going to make that judgment and assume, but as a Christian, as a worshiper of God, I do believe that God created me. If you don't believe that, that's fine. I hope you do realize that. But for this moment that we're here, just take it as it is. Because I'm not going to assume that everybody's sitting or everybody believes in God. All right, you don't know who came in here. So I think you should. You don't know what business they're coming with. You don't know the reason why they're here, like I said early on. So I'm not going to make any assumptions. But, yeah. They describe David as, Stephen said, the apple of God's eye, right? Like I said earlier, he's supposed to be the closest thing to us right now, us Christians right now. Because God created us in his image, right? He knows the faults we have. He knows we're going to sin. He knows that if I don't want to do something at 6 o'clock in the morning, but Stephen really needs me to do it. He knows I might lie to get out of it, which is kind of hard now because I live with him, but he knows I'm a lie to get out of it if I don't want to do it, right? He knows that if I haven't been to class for the past 3 days and there was a test, and y'all see some people like laughing right now because I haven't been to class for the past 3 days, and I missed a test.
Mm.
Yeah, like, just because I'm up here don't mean I'm the supposed, poster child for this student. I'm a terrible student. I get A's and stuff, but I'm still a terrible student, right? So he knows I hit up my teacher today and told him, hey, so-and-so happened when it didn't happen, right? Just so I can make up the test. Like I said, I'm not a pastor. Don't be judging me, right? I'm just here to tell y'all what God told me to tell y'all. Like I said, I have a bet. I'm trying to win that. So, yeah, that's basically it. The Lord is my shepherd. What does shepherd mean?
Caretaker.
Okay. Like, in the simplest understanding of the word, who is a shepherd?
Person that takes care of sheep.
Thank you. Sheep. Nah, like, you know. Don't be laughing at my sheep impersonation, but yeah, right? A shepherd is a person that takes care of sheep. Like I said, this is a scripture. Well, most of the songs were written by David, but this is a song that he wrote, right? Giving himself to God and describing God's character. He says, the Lord is my shepherd. Right? The Lord is my shepherd. He didn't say, a Lord, or God, or Almighty, whatever. Right? He said, the Lord. Right? That's giving him a title and an ownership. Right? If I come and I say DeAndre, which is why I asked y'all what namesake is, right? If I tell you DeAndre is 7 feet tall and, you know, has a plane, you know, whatever, which I hope you get there, but he's not that right now, right? But then you have this idea of who he might be, right? I tell you Stephen is 4'5". Right? Can't play basketball. Don't got no moves, you know, he don't got no ball handling skills. That's the idea you're gonna have of him. Right? That's what I'm describing Stephen with. That's, if you don't know Stephen, that's basically what he is to you. Right? David knows who God is. Right? David knows what God means to him. David knows he's not perfect. David knows that he's going to sin as much as he's human, you know, we're all human. Sometimes we try not to, or we don't bring ourselves to that level, but we are, right? God knows our flaws. God knows what we lack, the areas that we need help in. But then he still lets us go on and do stuff. You be out here wilding, like, just doing crazy things. Like, you see people drunk at all times, like, all times of the night, just walking around, saying whatever they want to say, singing whatever they want to say, doing whatever they want to do. Right, why does God allow that? If he says, like my example earlier, from point A to point B, why is he allowing them to take different routes, knowing that they might never get to that point B that he created them for? Why is he letting them do that? Right, that's where his character comes in. For his name's sake. That's for his honor. Right? Even though it doesn't benefit him to do that in that moment, he still does it. He still gives them breath. He still gives them life. He still gives them grace, even though they don't deserve it. We all don't deserve that. But he still gives it to us regardless of what we do because he loves us. Right? That's another thing too. This Bible study, we're going to bring God to a human level. Like I said, logic, right? If most of the time we think about God as this high and mighty person that we can't like break him up, like into, we can't relate, right? That's why I asked y'all the question. If y'all created something, right, that you told them do this and that, and they decide not to, what would you do? Let's not put human life, because sometimes people don't want to kill people. Is. Let's say you create a robot, right? Glad any programmers or anything? No, there you go. You create a robot, right? Or you create a software or something. And you tell it, when I walk into the house, turn the lights on, right? If you keep walking in the house and the lights don't turn on, what you gonna do?
throughout the whole thing.
Okay.
Well,
just,
I mean,
just throw it out. Don't compare it to human, man. I know you know where I'm going with it, but don't compare it to. What would you do?
Maybe like try to like fix it.
Okay.
Don't
try to fix it. What if it doesn't work?
Then you throw it.
Okay. So two chances. think about how many times you messed up just today. Let's say today is your whole life, right? Every minute counts for however many years you live on this earth. How many times have you messed up today? Yeah, you might not have, like, went out smoking. You might have actually told the truth today. You might have done whatever that you're supposed to do. But did you pray today? Did you thank God for giving you breath today? Did you see somebody who needed help and help them today? Right? It's like, we always try to, we always try to take the short way out of things, right? God said things that he said in the Bible specifically for us to follow, because he knows, right? Let's say you being the creator of whatever you created, you know what its potential is, right? You know if everybody can walk in the house and the lights magically come on, you know that's a service to humanity, right? Not just for you. Even if it's just for you, though, you know that's whatever, however many seconds it's saving you, looking for the light switch, right? Trying to turn it on. What happens if you trip? Why are you doing that? See, that saves you from that. That saves you from the hospital bills you're going to have to pay because you broke your hip. That saves you from all the people.